Kia ora. In this video, you will learn how to set a rodent bait station and some health and safety instructions regarding the use of bait station. This plastic black box is called a rodent bait station. This is designed for mice and rats. It would hold toxic baits inside. The mice and rats would enter the bait station through the entrance on the side. They would consume the toxic baits and they would die somewhere else. We encourage you to join our predator pouses, in which you would bait 4 times per year in February, April, August, and November for 28 days each. We do not encourage you to bait outside of the predator pouses because toxins can accumulate in the environment, and we would like to minimize our environmental impacts when we do our predator control.
A bait station must be locked all the time unless when you are setting or surfacing the station. Remember to wear gloves whenever you handle the bait station and the toxic baits. To open the bait station, you must use the black key that comes with the station. Press the key into the keyhole on the side and open the bait station. Inside the station, you would see 4 metal pins. That is designed specifically to hold the toxic bait securely inside the bait station so that it doesn't fall out and are out of reach of pets, children, and other non-target animals. So when you purchase baits in shops, remember that you are purchasing the correct type of baits, which are in blocks and have a hole in the middle instead of the pellets form. On day one of the predator pouse, set your bait station by putting 4 blocks of bait inside the bait station. Close and lock the bait station until you hear the click. Now your bait station is ready. Put the bait station along fence line or walls, ideally with vegetation cover, or anywhere you have seen rat activities. Ensure that the entrance on both sides of the bait stations are not blocked. Check your bait station on day 5 and day 14. Open the bait station and check for consumption. If baits are gone, replenish them. If you see moldy baits, also replace the moldy baits. Because when rats and mice eat moldy baits, they get sick and they wouldn't come back to the bait station anymore. We call it bait shyness. When you're done, close and lock the bait station and put it where you set it. On day 28, remove all the remaining baits in the bait station. You can throw them in general waste and end the pouse. You must remember to store toxic baits in their original container at all times, and store the container in areas where children and pets cannot get access to. If you observe any poisoning symptoms, you must take your pets to the vet or your children to the doctors immediately so that antidotes can be administered.